Have you ever wondered if different type of nitrogens could be the reason why your flowers taste bad at the end of your grow? Well, in this video, we're going to get into it. You're here with Mark Bowell at PerfectGardens.com.
Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. We got our $2.99 membership, and we have a VIP if you need a little more one-on-one, link down in the description.
I just want to say thank you so much for Tommy for asking this question. Hey Mark, love your videos, man. Question, I was at my local hydroponic store the other day, and the guy behind the counter told me that ammonium nitrate makes these plants taste bad. Is that true? Short answer, in my opinion, I would say yes, and this is why. Okay, so in this video, we're not going to break down where these nitrogens are derived from, although we are going to talk about the chemical composition so you can actually see on the molecular level and whether it's positive charges, negative charges, that there is actually a difference. And this is something that we all as growers really need to comprehend, that there is a difference. And on a microbiology level, these guys can see, and when I say these guys, that meaning the bacteria and the fungi, living biology can actually see, because these molecular atoms are at their eye level, right? If you had two strawberries in front of you, what are the characteristics of that strawberry that's going to make you want to reach out and grab one versus the other and eat it? It could be size, it could be color, it could be shape. The issue is, though, is that after you reached out and took a bite of it, it's already too late. You're already chewing into that nutrition of some level is going into your body. The only time you're going to actually know the difference is if you take the time to actually grab the other strawberry and see if there is a taste difference. Given that other strawberry that has a different characteristic, maybe it didn't look as nice, maybe it was smaller, maybe it was bigger, who knows? Only at that point, us as human beings can actually know the difference between these two strawberries and really realize, like, wow, one's really flavorful and the other one's kind of dull. Why are those two strawberries different? Well, on a microbiology level, all these bacteria can see these strawberries, right? And they're actually also susceptible to the same issues we're susceptible to. They're going to get attracted to certain types of characteristics, like nitrogen. These bacteria will go out and retrieve, thinking they're the same thing. Okay, so let's go ahead and quickly just break down the importance of nitrogen and this whole process. So nitrogen is responsible really for creating amino acids, and amino acids will create proteins. So what are amino acids? What are proteins? Amino acids are just single individual acids, right? And if you accumulate more than 20 amino acids in a single chain, that will create a protein chain. These protein chains are used to create the DNA, right? The DNA goes on to create leaves, stems, and develops the characteristics of that phenotype or genetics or cultivars, whatever you want to use. Although nitrogen is a gas, and I actually just created another video about nitrogen. If you haven't checked it out, please do so. It actually goes way more into depth. I am going to be repeating a number of things from that other video just to answer this question. Tommy actually just asked this question right after I finished the other one, so I thought I'd be more specific on this one. Nitrogen, to be available to plants, has to go through something called a nitrogen cycle. And through this nitrogen cycle, it is nitrogen fixation, assimilation, modification, nitrification, and denitrification. So what does this all mean? Well, the nitrogen fixation and assimilation is where the nitrogen actually get fixed. And when it says fixed, it means something's holding on to it. That gas has been absorbed and it's no longer a gas. It's a different chemical composition. As you can see over here, I made this green and this one red because this is the natural pathway of nitrogen to make it available to your plants in different forms. But it has to go through this pathway before different nitrogens can actually be taken up into the plant. I put these down here because these are man-made chemicals that do not follow the natural pathway. Ammonium nitrogen, nitrate, nitrites, ammonia, all these can also be made by man, and once they get altered, they become a synthesized chemical. Okay, so let's go back over here to nitrogen fixation and assimilation. So nitrogen will get fixated initially, naturally, by two separate ways. The first way is going to be by lightning storms. And this is actually like a quick release nitrogen. The bacteria is more of a slow release nitrogen. So the nitrogen, how it follows its fixation and assimilation. So when you have a lightning bolt, Lightning will split the atoms and will make nitrogen and oxygen combine together very quickly, creating nitrogen dioxide. At this point, it will combine to water, creating nitric acid. And at this point, the rain is falling down with nitric acid. That type of nitrogen is immediately available to the plant. That's why when it rains, the hillsides become green immediately, because that is a fast release nitrogen. And when the plants take it up, that's the assimilation part. So I should have actually moved the NHO3 more over here, because it's the assimilation portion. The other way the nitrogen gets fixated is through bacteria. So bacteria will absorb it, creating ammonia. And right here, as you can see, these bacteria are absorbing the nitrogen. And through ammonia, the assimilation process happens. And we're talking about the chemical composition side. This is also where scientists go in and try to say, hey, this is the exact same thing. Which at times, if it is ammonia, I would say, okay, sure, go ahead. You know what I mean? It's like, I'm not a scientist. I really can't tell exactly, but I do think that this is a cheap way of providing food. It's like going to a sit-down restaurant every single night. Obviously, sit-down restaurants are much better than going to McDonald's every single night. Although, having a really good home-cooked meal is a lot better than having a sit-down restaurant. And that's kind of how like I like to make these comparisons. When you use bacteria, these bacteria are creating a homemade meal for your plants. When you are just giving ammonia or the higher nitrogens like ammonium nitrogen, and again, I'm really specifically talking about these two. When growers and scientists actually give the plants these two specific nitrogens, they're doing a much better job for the microbiology, because this is actually the type of nitrogen your microbiology can still eat and enjoy. Like we said again, right? You're sitting down at a restaurant eating that. The food was better prepared and slightly a little bit better quality than going to McDonald's. And you really have to think about this, right? A lot of us don't really see the impact of eating at McDonald's. Well, actually, if you watch that documentary with the guy that goes Super Size Me, I think it was, right? He went to McDonald's for 30 days. What happened to him? Got extremely overweight. Yeah, is he still alive? Of course he is. But what is the well-being or the quality of life? That's where it gets reduced. And we can see that just over a course of 30 days of what can happen to the human body. Well, in this situation, when you're giving these types of nitrogens, which that's what you do, you see urea, that's what you're doing, you are bypassing all the microbiology and you're making something immediately available to the plant. And you're really not even bypassing the microbiology. It's because the microbiology doesn't want to eat it. They recognize it for what it is and says, it's kind of rotten. I'm going to walk away from this. And the issue with that is when all the microbiology walks away and the fungi no longer really have a purpose, because the fungi does a modification, right? It's holding on to the ammonium, the NH4+, and it's converting it into nitrites and nitrates. But through this entire cycle, it's actually more of like a slow release for this nitrogen. And the major issue with using salt-based fertilizers is that these salts are water-soluble. All these other chemical compositions, they're water-soluble through cation exchanges. All this other fertilizer is immediately available because it's water-soluble. And the issue with this is that plants don't take up fertilizer that quickly. Using a fertilizer-based technique, you kind of have to keep force-feeding your plants and keep providing nutrients as the plants are taking up water so the plants survive. With microbiology, things are getting captured, they're getting processed, they're getting accumulated, which is the reason why I'm actually going to come over here and show you the molecule of chlorophyll. And what's really interesting about chlorophyll and the human blood cell is they're actually similar in their chemical composition. The only difference is that the one center molecule is magnesium, and the human blood cell, it is iron. But the rest is all the same. And that's why when you're using blood meal, bone meal, all these other things, they have different types of nitrogen or phosphorus or calcium because of the certain types of deposits that get accumulated in different parts of these animal body parts. This is also a little key insight to understanding more about magnesium and the significance around magnesium and why magnesium will pop up in your cocoa grows or throughout your entire grow, and is always why it's always like that additional bottle they always push, right? Well, it's because everything binds to magnesium. So what you have right here is you have 55 carbons, you have 70 hydrogens, you have 6 oxygens, 4 nitrogens, and 1 magnesium molecule. So right here, this center part is the magnesium. Then these 4 right here are the nitrogen, the blue. These reds right here are the oxygens. And then the gray and the blacks are either your carbon or your hydrogen. And when all of these things accumulate, you have the ability for chlorophyll to take place. And what's chlorophyll? Chlorophyll is the exchange of carbon dioxide and water. And when light hits it, sugars, different crystalline structures, and oxygen get released. And when you go back in the opposite direction, it's actually the same formula in the opposite direction for respiration. Again, right, plants take up CO2 and they give us back oxygen. So right here, once again, so these two parts is you're fixing it, you're using it, you're storing it. That's what the fungi do. They retrieve it and they hold on to it until the bacteria can process it. And then the denitrification is where nitrogen becomes a gas again. And this is also where you end up having dead spots, because the only real two ways for nitrogen to become gas is for it to evaporate back into the atmosphere through water vapors evaporating and coming back into the atmosphere, or through a fire. So the last and final piece is really understanding the bacteria, right? The bacteria are the catalyst. They create the coenzymes that make minerals available to the plant. So once again, guys, bacteria produce coenzymes. So it's not just that bacteria is fixating and holding onto the nitrogen, but in addition to that, it's creating coenzymes, additional coenzymes, things that creates a catalyst. Catalyst, it speeds things up. So it creates these coenzymes that makes your other minerals available to those plants and allows those minerals, trace minerals, to actually be processed. So in your soil system, you have billions of bacteria working for you and you have millions of fungi. When you use these other types of nitrogens, it creates an environment for your bacteria to get shut down. It says, hey, if you're not going to use me, I'm just going to sit here and wait until you want to use me. Then your fungi colony begins to get destroyed, and before you know it, there's nothing to hold on to these nitrates, which leach back into your water system. And because you are providing these nitrogens to your plant, and your plants do look green and look healthy, you don't realize that other minerals and their coenzymes are never getting produced because your plant looks green. And if it looks green, what's wrong with it, right? Well, all those other coenzymes and all those other minerals is the buffet, right? It's what's going to allow your plant to get really healthy and to be able to access that higher terpene profile. And it's not until you begin to examine the terpene profile at the end of your grow do you begin to realize how healthy your actual plant was through the entire grow cycle. And because we all know terpenes are flavor, you having less terpenes will end up at some point affecting your taste. A lot of people don't have any taste, so they can't really tell the difference. Most of our senses have been deadened down in our society. So again, we're just kind of used to going to McDonald's and not really knowing the difference between higher quality food. Although once you bite into a delicious strawberry, from that point into the future, you'll always have a reference point to knowing top shelf quality from lower quality. Please remember to like, share, and subscribe. I hope you enjoyed this video. Have a great grow, everyone.
Okay, so real quick, as we look at these products, we're going to jump down the very bottom where it says Open Sesame, Beastie Bloom, and Cha Ching. As you can see right here, that none of these products overlap. You use the Open Sesame first. They recommend 1/4 teaspoon per gallon. Then you jump over to a Beastie Blooms. And remember, so right now you're in the first 3 weeks into flowering is when you used Open Sesame. And you got to think about it, right? They're marking as Open Sesame, so starting those flowers. Beastie Blooms is to really get those flowers going is their marketing thought process. And so for there, you'll use the Beastie Blooms again, at 1/4 teaspoon per gallon for about 2 weeks. So weeks